Aloha, everybody. Welcome to Maui Karen Ann. As you can see, I'm cutting off some excess material. I've just used an old pillowcase, scrunched it up into a design that I like, and I'm cutting off the extra now and getting ready for the next step. Okay, the next step is, I thought maybe the spray starch would work. It didn't work. So now I'm taking Elmer's glue, pouring that into a little dish, adding a little water, I didn't measure it at all, and then mixing it up, and then I'm going to paint the whole thing with this to make and let it dry overnight and let it get real stiff. Okay, I've painted on the glue and water and it's dried. Now I'm taking spackle, and to the spackle I'm adding the white acrylic paint. And I'm just going to paint over everything as we go along. And I think you'll see that it looks like I have missed some spots, and you're probably yelling, "Oh, you missed a spot. Go back, go back, go back." Yes, I did go back. I turned the canvas around and saw the areas that I had missed. I was real careful. I did cover everything. I even covered it on the edges. I think you can see that I stapled the cloth to begin with to keep it taut. And now I'm putting on the spackle and the white paint. You can color your spackle any color. I could have colored it purple, red, blue, whatever. But I just want this one to be white this time. So as you can see, there's a spot I missed right there, but I come back and get it later. Okay, it's dried. Now I've got the white paint, and I'm just going to paint the white all over the dried spackle. And as you can tell, it doesn't really make a lot of difference, but it does seal it better. So I'm going to go ahead and I paint around the edges, and I use brush strokes. When I finish an area, I try to use all my brush strokes going the same way. So if there are any strokes when it dries, at least they're all going to look uniform. Don't forget to subscribe, you know it's free. And here is a picture of the finished painting. Thank you.